Kimchi Warrior is the latest popular motion comic series to be released on the internet. It is the story of a superhero who gets his powers from eating the Korean superfood, kimchi. The man behind this martial arts comic series is Korean film director Kang Young-man. Ever since he released his first motion picture in the year 2000, this film director has received numerous awards for his independent films. Meet the film director who has left a lasting impression on the world of independent movies. Hello and welcome to Heart, I'm Colleen Park. As a lot of you may know, Hollywood is known as the dream factory for films. But you may also know that a film production only has a mere 1% chance of making it to the box offices. But our guest today has overcome many adversities to make or find his own style of success in Hollywood for 10 years. Please welcome film director Kang Young-man. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thanks
for
having me. Nice to have you here. Yes. Your short film, the comic series, mm-hmm. Kimchi Warrior, has attracted a lot of attention on the internet. Can you tell us about it?
Okay. Kimchi Warrior is like kind of unique, based upon the Korean character. It's like Popeye version Korean, like eating, instead of eating spinach, actually eating the kimchi and then get some supernatural powers. And then defeat all kind of disease. Yeah, that was actually a basic concept. And also, it's kind of few people, like, they thought kimchi is kind of like, they try to make fun of the food because the smell is bad. Mm-hmm. Also, taste kind of in the beginning kind of weird. But eventually, I mean, when they like it and they really like it, right? So, so those kind of like superhero character eating that kind of kimchi and get some power. So that's why they like those kind of basic concept, the character, and then little, at the same time kind of funny. Yeah, that's why I draw a lot of attention through the internet. Yeah.
Well, how did you first come up with the idea to do this? Why did it start?
First one, honestly, is my mother, my mom. My mom was an excellent cook for making kimchi. And I've been in the States like almost 15 years. And sometimes, you know, having a hard time, you know, like homesick, right? The missing hometown, and especially, you know, miss my the kimchi my mother cook, and at the same time I have like rice cook and then one the kimchi mm-hmm. only for food mm-hmm. and think about, oh my god, my life is so miserable here, you know, why I stay here, I have to go back to Korea, forget about the filmmaking. And suddenly it'll come up into my mind, okay, there's a something, you know, the meaning, you know, for this. And then suddenly come up about like the Popeye character and then mm-hmm. eating spinach. Mm-hmm. And then, okay, maybe eating kimchi and then kind of make a character kind of funny. So that's actually a start.
Well, the character itself has a few weapons, doesn't he?
Yeah.
They're kind of funny weapons.
Mm-hmm.
Like the, what was it, the moonchucks? The nunchucks? The
moo. Like a Korean word, moo, mm-hmm. is a radish.
Right.
And then nunchuk. So
right.
Put together
put
the moonchucks.
Moonchucks.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and so this character mm-hmm. Fights all evil. It's uh-huh. sort of like any other superhero that we can see, like Superman and Spider-Man. Uh-huh. And is that what you were going after, is to find a Korean superhero?
Absolutely. Yeah, why not?
Well, you know, kimchi right now is a big, big, Korean food is gaining popularity all over the world,
yeah, yeah,
and it's perfect time. Did you think that, mm-hmm. did you know that the Korean food was going to be popular all around the world before you started this?
Of course, that's why like I started.
Mm.
It's the good timing, mm-hmm. you know, like especially food and the culture is the best way, you know, introduce the culture, their own country. So I think the kimchi is the best.
Mm-hmm.
That's why like, okay, why don't you put together with the entertainment and then put some martial art and then some like superhero character, and then that's the best way.
Well, yeah. Perfect, because you know mm-hmm. kimchi is it's supposed to have medicinal purposes, so mm-hmm. it all works out. A lot of the stories that I saw were fighting not evil people who are greedy, but like viruses, yeah. SARS, you know, all the health disease. Why focus on those things?
A few years ago, I read an article in the New York Times. There's an article about kimchi is good for curing SARS. Mm. So then that article actually, you know, come to my mind. And okay, then what about maybe just a few years back, right? It's H1N1 virus was right. like crazy, right?
Right.
At that time then, okay, why don't I make the superhero character Kimchi Warrior defeated H1N1 virus? So that's why I like to make that kind of style and then put some interesting the weapon. Weapon also, the superhero, all kind of weapon, they already use it. So let me try to think of something you know, different. Gotta be related with the kimchi. That's why with the, some, think about the nunchuck, it was Bruce Lee using this and maybe why don't you using a radish and there's anyway some like, some kind maybe connected and using right with the nunchuck. Also, there's a radish, each piece of radish is called the gakdugi.
Gakdugi, right.
So I put some of the gakdugi as a bullet and then using like a gun.
Right.
Yeah, those kind of style. Also, there's a like a long stick.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of just the stick, and there's the garlic. Using the garlic, this stick.
All right, all the potent ingredients that come together to make this hero a very big warrior. Do you envision this kimchi warrior becoming something like the Mickey Mouse of Asia?
I hope so. Yeah, actually, I dreaming. I really hope so, yeah. Like as a Mickey Mouse, Spider-Man, even Popeye, why not?
You drew all the characters yourself?
In the beginning.
In the beginning.
In the beginning, I drew the characters, and right now actually we have more artists. Yeah, it's a lot of work.
Oh, I'm sure. Well, animation is
yeah,
how many frames per second? You have plans to make the Kimchi Warrior into a feature film?
Yes, eventually first my idea was to make a feature film, but it takes time to get financed, so meanwhile like I gotta do something, so why don't I make some test some image, so that's why maybe I make animation, especially very, very popular these days is a web series through the YouTube. I mean, you can like advertise it on yourself, so that's the best way. So that's a few clips and then put in the YouTube, that's like showing around, yeah.
Up to now, you've produced independent films, and we have an aura about independent films. But with Kimchi Warrior, you plan to go into the commercial film business. Is that different for you?
Yeah, it's a little different structure, especially like the commercial film, gotta be a lot of policy. Also, sometimes like as a director, I gotta like some like give up. You know, independent film, I mean, even though a little like small budget, but director has most of power.
Right.
But commercial film is like, well, producer have a power. You know, that's a little different.
Is that okay for you? Do you feel all right with that?
This is fine. This is fine. I mean, I want to do both, actually. I want to do commercial film, at the same time, independent films. That way, but it's a good thing for commercial films that you can show to, I mean, variety audience. You know, that's also I want to do, too, you know, yeah.
All right. Yeah. The first feature film by movie director Kang Young-man was released in the year 2000, and he has until today produced 5 independent films and set new records in the world of independent films in the U.S., and we'll hear more about it when we return. First, let's take a look at film director Kang Young-man on the set of his motion picture.